St. Isaac. And joining us live in our studio, we are joined by the CEO of Entergy-New Orleans this morning. We have Charles Rice joining us to give us an update on the situation in both New Orleans and Jefferson Parish. We know a lot of people very concerned about this. You all have been making some progress, but still, over the last few days, you've really been taking the heat for a lot of the complaints that a lot of people have when it comes to power. And we should mention first off that you represent Entergy-New Orleans, not Entergy-Louisiana, although you've been fielding questions and complaints about both organizations, the sister company as well. So first of all, where do we stand in terms of outages in Orleans Parish?
Well, let me say this. First of all, we're a team, mm-hmm. Entergy-New Orleans, Entergy-Louisiana. It's one team. Mm-hmm. Bill Mole is a personal friend of mine, mm-hmm. And look, taking the heat, that just kind of comes with the territory. I know people are frustrated. We know people are frustrated. And we're doing the best that we can to restore service. But right now, I can tell you that just in the metro area, the seven parish area, from last night till this morning, we restored about 51,000 people. We're about 62% in Orleans and Jefferson that people are restored. And if you recall, our goal was 70% by tomorrow, so I'm fairly comfortable that we're going to exceed that goal, and our guys are still working hard, they'll continue to work hard, and we're all in this together, and we feel everyone's pain, and we hope to have everyone restored as soon as possible.
And the goal is 70% by tomorrow, 90% by Wednesday. This is in Orleans Parish.
And that's going to be for Jefferson, too.
And Jefferson,
yes,
as well. A lot of people, complaining about seeing these trucks at these staging locations, and it appears that these crews are not doing anything. Explain to us, when we drive by a staging site and we see these hundreds of trucks or 50 trucks, you pick the number, what are we seeing exactly?
There are a lot of things going on there. It could be the guys are eating breakfast. It could be that they're resting. It could be that they're, waiting for an assignment. It could also be that they're waiting for one part of a job to get finished before they can go out and do their job. It's really dangerous for us to have all these trucks out there unnecessarily. There's a method to our madness. I think people can see we've made great progress, so you can see the system is working. We're already at 62% right now. Mm-hmm. If I recall, I think that exceeds where we were for Gustav at this particular time. So we're really working very, very hard to restore your service.
And I saw an interview you did with my colleague Tiffany Bradley, and you said that no one expected Isaac, a Category 1, to do as much damage as it did. This was not a typical Category 1 storm. Is that what's causing some of these delays? And another thing you pointed out, a lot of people didn't evacuate. So typically, people would be a day or two without power, but the people who chose to stay are now 4 and 5 days without power.
Yeah, and this was an interesting storm, I'll put it that way. And this was kind of unusual because usually people have left town, they're gone for 2 or 3 days, they come back. Most of them, when they come back, their power is already restored, or they may be without power for one day. In this particular case, the majority of the people chose to stay, so people have been without power sometimes from when the storm first hit. Mm-hmm. So that, and then the fact that this storm sat over us for 2 days, 2.5 days, and even though it was a Category 1, 2.5 days with winds blowing with gusts up to close to 100 miles an hour, it's going to do a lot of damage. So in this particular case, I don't think anyone could have anticipated a lot of the things that happened with the storm. The storm surge in LaPlace, the flooding in Tangipahoa on the North Shore. These are all things that no one would expect to occur with a Category 1 storm.
And earlier this morning, I spoke and interviewed Jefferson Parish President John Young. And he's been a very vocal critic of Entergy as a result of Hurricane Isaac. He said he met with Entergy on yesterday. They met behind closed doors. They discussed some of the things that could have been done better as a result of Isaac. In your opinion, what would you give Entergy's performance for this event? What could have been done better?
I would say we've done a very good job. And the reason I say that is because we planned for this year round. We brought in resources prior to the storm even striking, before it even hit land. But let me say this. There are always things that we can do better. After every storm, we refine and refresh our processes. We do what I would call, I'm a former military guy, an after action review, where we talk about things that went right, we talk about things that went wrong. In this particular case, one of the big issues was the fact that our normal staging areas outside of Orleans Parish were flooded. Slidell, Hammond area received unexpected flooding. Normally, we would be doing a lot of these processes outside of Orleans, and then when the trucks got into the city, they would be ready to roll. In this particular case, we actually had to do a lot of the stuff that's normally done before they get to the city, inside the city, and that's the reason why you saw a lot of trucks sitting there.
All right, and another complaint that people specifically, Jefferson Parish President John Young, not enough boots on the ground, no mobilization, no equipment mobilized, disorganization on Entergy's part, not taking this seriously enough. All of the above, your take on that and your response to that.
I consider John Young a friend. He's entitled to his opinion, but I would tell you that I think we've done a great job. We were prepared, even before the storm struck land. We already had close to 500 people positioned, ready to come into this area, ready to work. Prior to every storm striking land, or when the storm's in the Gulf, we're running prediction models on damage. We ran our prediction models based upon that. We requested resources, and resources normally come in three waves. The first wave arrived on time, the second wave arrived on time, and the third wave arrived on time. And going back to the truck issue too, New Orleans is kind of like the gateway to Louisiana. If you notice, every single highway in the state comes into New Orleans. Every major highway in the state comes into New Orleans. So you had trucks coming in here, and we had 10,000 people coming in, and those trucks were being dispersed all over the state. Mm-hmm. So a lot of those trucks that people may have seen that they considered sitting idle, those individuals were resting before they were moving out to other areas of the state, and not only New Orleans, but also the entire metro area.
And we also are told that the New Orleans City Council was looking at a meeting with Entergy New Orleans and discussing some of the things that could have been done better. We know that you all are regulated by the council. We know that Jefferson Parish President John Young is also looking at competition in the parish now as a result of the what he calls the failure to perform by Entergy.
Well, let me say this. The Louisiana Public Service Commission and the New Orleans City Council, we welcome their scrutiny. We welcome them to look at our response. We welcome them to look at the resources that were expended in us restoring service on the storm. That is their right. By law, they're allowed to do that. They review our rates every year. So we welcome that scrutiny. And I can tell you this, we're the best in the business at this. So we welcome them to take a look. Whenever there's a storm across the country, everyone wants our resources to come in because we have the most experience out there. So again, we welcome them to look at it. We're transparent. We're open. We don't have anything to hide. So please take a look at it, as is their right.
And before we let you go, once again, those numbers, the number of outages right now and what we expect 70% to be restored in Orleans Parish and Jefferson Parish by Monday, and 90% in both parishes on Wednesday.
Yep, that's correct. And again, we're already at 62%, 65%. So there's no reason to believe we will not exceed those numbers.
Thank you so much for joining us once again. Charles Rice, who is the CEO of Entergy New Orleans. Thank you for being a part of our program and answering some of these questions this morning.